Good morning, Vandan. Today we are going to discuss briefly about decision trees. It is natural and intuitive to classify a pattern through a sequence of questions in which the next question asked depends on the answer to the current question. For example, let's consider a set of creatures, birds and animals, and if I want to identify elephant out of those creatures, then the questions I am going to ask are as follows. For example, I can say whether that creature can fly or not. If you answer like it won't fly, then my second question will be, is it having two legs or four legs? Then if you say that's having four legs, then I can ask my next question to be, is that animal, is that creature is big or small? If you say big, then I'll like to ask my next question to be, is it having trunk? Then if you answer like yes, that is having trunk, then I can say the creature that you are having is elephant. That means with some sequence of questions, I can try to form a pattern for that particular object or for that particular class or for that particular creature, right? That's what we are going to do in decision trees. For example, this is green color watermelon. It can be class, it can have the properties as follows. This watermelon is a fruit and that is very big and the color is green. In that way I can classify, right? And this is yellow grapefruit. This is not lemon, this is grapefruit. The difference between lemon and grapefruit is, see, both of them are yellow. Lemon can be yellow, grapefruit also can be yellow. But major difference between them is size. Size of grapefruit is medium size. Size of lemon is very, very small. Size of lemon is small, size of grapefruit is medium size. Based on size, I can differentiate them, right? And both of them are medium size fruits. And one is red colored apple, another one is green colored apple. And here, this is banana. The color of this one is yellow and shape is thin. Thin shape, right? This is not round. And this is lemon. Shape of this one is round and color is yellow and the size of this one is small. And we have black color, green color and red colored grapes. And each of them are small in size, right? And red colored cherry fruits. This is also small like this red colored grape. But the taste of this red colored grape is sour. The taste of this red cherry is sweet. There is a difference in the taste, right? That means here the features corresponds to the properties. Properties of the objects. Properties means here that can be taste, that can be size, that can be shape, that can be color, like that. These are features or properties that we are going to use in our decision trees. Just consider this fruits classification task with the help of a decision tree. This starting node is called as root node and these last nodes are called as leaf nodes. These are called as leaf nodes, the last nodes. This is a root node in the tree. You can think it like a tree. This is a root and these are the branches followed by finally leaves, right? Here leaves corresponds to category, right? Separate category for each and every leaf. You can try to see. This leaf corresponds to watermelon. This leaf corresponds to apple. This leaf corresponds to grape. This corresponds to grapefruit, lemon, banana, apple, cherry, and grape. And there is no mixture of two fruits in the same leaf, right? Leaf contains pure class or pure category. Each and every leaf corresponds to single category. There is no mixture of categories, right? and this is a root node, and this branch corresponds to, see, at each and every root, at each and every node, these are the nodes. At each and every node, I'll try to ask some question, or that question is based on particular property or particular feature. You can think of this one like a feature or a property. Feature or property of that object that we are going to test. First question I am going to ask at the root node is, for example, let's construct color as a root node. If you want to construct size as a root node, or shape as a root node, or taste as a root node, that's up to you. Here we are considering color as a root node. I'll try to ask the color. What is the color of that particular fruit? Then if you answer green, then my next question is, what is the size of that fruit? If the size is big, then I can simply say that's a watermelon, just based on color and size, big size and that is green color. Based on these two properties, I can try to say that that's a watermelon. Suppose the color is green and my next question or next property or next feature I am going to test is size. If I say size is medium, green color, medium size means that is green apple, and green color, small size means that is green grape. Suppose instead of green color, if the answer I got is yellow, then what is my next node is shape. Shape is my next node. Instead of testing for size, instead of asking a question related to size, I'm trying to ask a question related to shape. Based on my answer, I want to change my next question, or change my next feature, or next property I am going to ask. I want to change that one, right? There will be no need to maintain size as a second feature for this entire tree. For all the three branches, size is not the feature, right? For the center branch, we can see shape is the feature that we are going to test. Once we got yellow, I like to ask a question like, what is the shape of that one? If the answer is round, then I can go for, round means there are two possibilities, right? Yellow and round means there are two possibilities. One is lemon and the other one is grapefruit. If that is big size, then that is grapefruit. If that is small size, then that is a lemon. After shape, if I got it like round, yellow and round, my next question will be size. If that is big, that is grapefruit. If that is small, that is lemon. Like that, I can separate, right? Once I got yellow, then if I ask a question like, what is the shape of that one? If I got answer like thin, then I can classify that particular object as a banana. Suppose if I got answer to this color as red, then the possibilities I am having are apple, cherry and grape. Red cherry is there, red grape is there, red apple is there. Based on size, I can try to separate apple from these two things, right? If I ask a question like whether the size is medium or small, if I got answer like that is medium size, what is the size of that one? If that is medium size, then I can say red and medium corresponds to red apple. And if I got size to be small, red color and small size means there are two possibilities. That can be either cherry or that can be either grape. Now my next question will be, our next property or next feature I am going to test is taste. What is the taste of that one? If I got answer like sour, that is grape. If I got answer like sweet, that is a cherry. That means you can try to observe this decision tree clearly. This feature got repeated twice, right? Size, not only twice, thrice. Along this, I got twice. And in the subsequent section, in the next section also, I got size, right? Not only at this level, not only at level 1, at level 2 also, I got size feature second time, right?
Now you can write objects. That means you can use the features in different levels and multiple times. That's also possible, right? And there can be multiple features in the same level. Based on the answer you got for your previous level, you can try to change this question. If you got a green, I'll change my question. I'll let it go for size. If I go for size, I can separate them easily. Instead of size, if I go for shape, what will happen here is grape is round, apple is round, watermelon is round, right? That means with the help of this shape feature, I can't separate all the three things, right? They are all are round. I won't separate them with the help of shape property. With the help of size property, I can separate them. Whether it is big, I can say watermelon, medium means apple, small means grape. Shape won't be helpful in this case, right? In this particular sequence. That's why I need to go for size. I need to separate them into different classes as early as possible. That's what my ultimate goal. Here shape might be helpful as compared to size. Here size will be helpful as compared to taste feature or shape feature. Here also same thing, right? If I go for shape feature, these three are round. That won't help for classification purpose, right? Here shape will be helpful because banana is thin. I can separate banana from grapefruit and lemon. Here shape will be helpful. In this case, shape is not helpful, right? It depends. The simple decision tree in figure 8.1 illustrates one benefit of trees over many other classifiers such as neural networks, interpretability. You can have good interpretability with the help of decision trees, but this is not the case with neural networks. We can't have much clear interpretation with neural networks. We don't know what's going on in neural networks. That we can see later. It is straightforward matter to render the information in such a tree as logical expressions. For example, suppose these are the properties I am going to test. Taste, color, shape and size. And if someone gave me the answer as follows, taste is sweet, color is yellow, shape is thin, size is medium. Based on these feature outcomes, I can try to classify this as banana because banana is yellow in color and shape is thin, right? Based on just these two features, I can try to classify it as a banana, right? Actually, banana is having all these four properties: banana, sweet, yellow, thin, and medium. These are the properties of banana: the medium size and thin shape and yellow color, sweet. If I try to have this as my feature vector, this is my feature vector, and I can classify based on these four features as follows. This is my feature vector, for example. This is my feature vector given by someone, and I want to test what is that fruit. What I'll do is, first I'll check for color, right? Here they mentioned color as yellow. Color is yellow. Once I got yellow color, I'll check for shape. And here they mentioned shape as thin, right? Thin shape. Based on this shape, I can go to this leaf node where I am having only banana as a class, right? It's a pure class. Pure means one single category should be there. Just with the help of these two features, I am able to classify, right? Even though I am having four input features with me, with the help of just two features, I am able to classify. That's good for me, right? There is no issue with this. And second one is, we can occasionally get clear interpretation of the categories themselves by creating logical descriptions using conjunctions and disjunctions. For example, tree shows that apple corresponds to green and medium or red and medium. You can have a look into this. By looking into this decision tree, we can say that I want to check what are the properties of apple. This is apple, this is apple. This apple medium size and green color. And apple corresponds to medium size and red color. That means if that is medium size and green color, I can say apple. Or if that is medium size and red color, then also I can say it has apple. I am able to extract the properties of that particular fruit with the help of decision tree, right? It means that I can interpret, right? I can understand very well. We can interpret it very easily. That's the benefit of decision trees. Finally, we note that trees provide a natural way to incorporate prior knowledge from human experts. In practice, though, such expert knowledge is of great use when the classification problem is fairly simple and the training set is small. In such scenario, human knowledge is okay. Instead of this one, by having so many classes and so many features I need to test, and the amount of data I am having also huge. In such scenario, it's better to do it automatic. Learning from the data. Instead of giving human knowledge, why can't you learn from the test data, training data? That's part of our plan. That can be done with the help of a CART, for example, CART, classification and regression trees. Now we turn to the matter of using training data to create or grow a decision tree. With the help of training data, we want to grow that tree or we want to form that decision tree automatically using some logics. We don't want to dump our human knowledge straight away into the tree. That should learn from data, training data. We assume that we have a set D of labeled training data and we have decided on a set of properties that can be used to discriminate patterns, but do not know how to organize the test into a tree. That's what the plan behind CART, classification and regression trees. We'll try to give a data set. In the data set, by default, we are having input feature vectors. Some x bar d cross 1 is there, right? D is the dimension of that feature vector. For example, here d equal to 4. D equal to 4, the features we construct are shape, size, color, and taste, right? These are the four features that we considered. Those values will be there in that training data, and along with that one, that label also there. For example, if that is banana, along with this 4x1 feature vector, we will have comma banana output. That label data we are having. We will try to dump all these training samples, all these labeled samples to that decision tree classifier, and that decision tree classifier will try to learn the structure or learn that kind of decision tree with the help of these labeled training set. Clearly, any decision tree will progressively split that set of training examples into smaller and smaller subsets. It would be ideal if all the samples in each subset had the same category label. In that case, we would say that each subset was pure and could terminate that portion of the tree. Finally, our ultimate goal in decision trees is, at the end, for the leaf node, we should have only single category. We should not have a mix of categories. Because our target is we need to classify into single class, right? We need to classify the given object or given fruit in that example as one of the possibilities. That's what our plan, right? It means our leaf node should be pure. Usually, however, there is a mixture of labels in each subset, and then For each branch, we will have to decide either to stop spitting and accept an imperfect decision, or instead select another property and grow the tree further. We may have some overfitting issues. If some noisy data is there in your training set, for example, round color, round and yellow color, medium size is treated as banana. For example, there is some misclassification problem. There is noisy data, right? And if you go till the extreme case, if you want to make it like complete pure, then there is a chance for misclassification. That's not a good thing, right? There's some sort of overfitting, trying to by heart training data along with noise that will try to learn if you go till that pure node. There are some problems, there are some issues of overfitting. You try to go up to pure leaf nodes when the data is noisy. If that is not noisy data, then no problem. This suggests an obvious recursive tree growing process. Given the data represented at a node, either declare that node to be a leaf or find another property to use to split the data into subsets. For example, let's have a look into this playing tennis game. This is day 1, day 2, day 3, up to day 14. We are having training examples. It's a test sample. And this is a weather, this corresponds to weather, about outlook, about humidity, about wind. This corresponds to output class label, playing, whether to play or not, yes or no, I will play tennis or I will not play tennis based on these features. This is the plan. These are the three features we are having: outlook of the weather, humidity of the weather, and wind of that weather. These are the three features that we are considering, and based on these three features we need to say whether to play or not to play. That's what our plan. We have 14 such training samples. This no corresponds to class 2, yes corresponds to class 1. For example, you can say like that. The possible outlooks are sunny, overcast, rain, and the possible humidity are high and normal, and possible winds are weak and strong. These are the possibilities. Three features we are having, and these are possibilities for them. And if I try to consider root node as outlook, out of three features I consider this outlook as my root node or first feature. Let's ask a question like, what is the outlook? If I got the answer like overcast, then I will play tennis without any doubt. You can try to see. Overcast, try to look into overcast cases. Overcast, yes, I will play. Overcast, I will play. Overcast, I will play tennis. Overcast, I will play tennis, right? In all overcast cases, I'll try to play tennis, right? Without any doubt. Now we got pure label, right? This is called a leaf node. This is one of the leaf nodes. There is no combination of S, no, right? All samples which corresponds to overcast are S, corresponds to S only. Suppose if I got outlook as sunny, let's look into sunny. I won't play, and here also I won't play, but here I play, right? Sunny S. That means there is a combination of both, right? When that is sunny, there is a mixture of both, S, no. Sometimes I will play, sometimes I won't play. If I want to have pure class at the end, I need to get the help of one more feature. Now I will try with humidity. I will try to ask a question about humidity. If that is high, I won't play. If that is normal, I will play. You can try to see this. When that is sunny, and humidity is normal, I am going to play. Yes, right? When that is sunny, humidity is high, then I won't play. That will work out, right? Just with the help of these two features, I am able to say whether to play or not to play. If that is sunny and humidity is normal, then I will play. Or if that is overcast, straight away I can say I will play. If that is rain, then if that is rainy day, I will try to look into wind. If that is rainy day, I will try to say this. Yes, I will play. Yes, I will play. No, I won't play. No, I won't play. This is a combination of both, right? Now I'll try to look for wind. If the wind is weak, I'll play. Wind is weak, I'll play. Rain and wind is strong, I won't play. Rain and wind is strong, I won't play. In that way, I can do, right? I'll try to ask a question about wind. Strong, I won't play. If that is weak, I'll play. You can try to see. In the same level, here I am asking about humidity, here I am asking about wind. It depends. If you want, you can try to exchange this one. Here try to ask about wind, here try to ask about humidity, and try to see whether you are able to get the leaf nodes, pure leaf nodes or not. This is your assignment. Try to interchange both. Instead of asking about humidity here, ask about wind and try to see whether you got all leaf nodes to be pure. If you don't get leaf nodes to be pure, then your next question should be about humidity. You can go for third feature and try to extend. You can do this. And one more assignment you are going to have is, instead of asking about outlook as a root node, try with humidity first. And instead of this outlook as a root node, in one more example, guys, try with wind as a root node and try to see what's going to happen. Try to extend till the end. Thank you.